Women are at the mercy of the cycle of the moon. Our menstrual cycle is a manifestation of the lunar cycle built into our cosmic bodies. So the woman is a physical manifestation of Unomkhubulwane, who rules the waters. Just as the moon rules the tides, the waters nourish and facilitate birth. And that's why the womb is filled with water when creating new life. Africans always understood that the Holy Trinity was the mother, the father, and the son, because that's in alignment with nature. That was the Holy Trinity, and later became the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit in Christian texts. The Holy Spirit is the mother. And that's also just according to common sense. It's just basic physics that male energy needs female energy in order for creation to take place. Males cannot reproduce amongst themselves. Even the resurrection, rebirth, and renewal of the green god Asa during the spring equinox occurs only because of Oset's action of reassembling his body. Women were highly venerated in African spirituality. Women had more rights in ancient Kemet than anywhere else in the ancient world. I mentioned in the previous video that kings often ruled with their mothers. King Shaka, one of the most powerful Zulu kings in history, was obsessed with his mother. He slaughtered anyone who didn't mourn her death after she passed. Currently, the king of the last absolute monarch in Africa, King Swati of Eswatini, also upholds the ancient Swati practice of ruling with his mother, Indlovugati, the queen mother. And I